Fashionably Yours is a pretty decent film. This was released in 2020. It's directed by Nimisha Mukerji. I apologise if I've mispronounced that. And it's written by Nicole, Avril and Nicole Baxter. And it stars Kat Graham as Lauren and Kendrick Sampson as Rob. And I really like the concept for this one. Lauren has decided that her career is not going where she wants it to be. She works in organising fashion, which is not really something I'd ever heard of. And it certainly seems like a really interesting career, but it's not where she wants it to be. So she decides it's time to move back to Scottsdale from Seattle. But she meets Rob, who is going to be doing the move for her, and he decides to make a bet. She can find three things that she loves about Seattle, or he'll do the move for free. And the film is partly about her exploring Seattle. Now, I don't know how much of this was filmed in Seattle. We absolutely get establishing shots, but IMDb says that it was filmed in Vancouver. So if anybody knows exactly how much of this was filmed in Seattle, I would be very keen to know. And that part of it I did think was quite interesting. And even if you don't live in Seattle, I don't live in Seattle, but I think it can allow us as viewers to also evaluate whether we get the most out of where we live. Because I think it's very easy to become complacent with your routine and going about your day, going on the same streets, visiting the same places. And I think this could give us all a nudge to see if we are actually exploring the world around us as much as we perhaps could. So I really enjoyed that concept. Rob is also a really likable character. I thought he was certainly very interesting and also a very good thing for Lauren, helping her to open herself up to new possibilities in a time when she's not really sure where her life is going. To be honest, her decision to move back home doesn't make a tremendous amount of sense, because she's moving because her career is not going where she wants it to be, but moving back home wouldn't rectify that problem. So I don't really understand why she decided to do that. Maybe I missed something. If that's the case, that's absolutely fine. But the motivation to just quit her job and go home didn't really seem like it was there. I don't really understand what she hoped to achieve. But I guess part of that was the point. She did say at one point that she didn't know, you know, what she was doing or what her plan was. And that's something that she really struggles with. Because as we learn, and this is what she's great at, she's very good at planning and organising. And for the first time in her life, it looks like that's not going to be so much of a box-ticking exercise for her, because she doesn't know what those boxes are that she has to tick. And I think that's definitely quite interesting in one regard, but at the same time, I still feel like quitting her job and going home wasn't going to solve the problem that she had. But nevertheless, it gave us an interesting narrative, and obviously we have the romantic aspect between Lauren and Rob as the narrative progresses, so does their potential romantic relationship, and I think they work really well together. As I said, Rob really was a great thing in Lauren's life at that time, and I really enjoyed watching them together as well. It's a really pleasant film. Fashionably Yours has an interesting narrative, likeable characters, and nothing that I think was too over the top. Sometimes with rom-coms, characters will completely overreact to situations, and other than Lauren quitting her job and moving home without really having any resolution to her problem, that was maybe a bit over the top. But other than that, I think everything was really enjoyable and definitely one that I'd recommend. I enjoyed watching it. Sounds like it would appeal to you, then I'd say Fashionably Yours is definitely worth checking out.